Hello and welcome to a new episode of Nurburgring Blast. So today's episode, we're going to be taking this, the Volkswagen ID.R round the Nurburgring. So this is the electric ring record holder. We're going to take it for a blast round the Nurburgring, 680 horsepower, all electric, one gear, and pretty fast, a lot of aero. So let's see how it gets on compared to the other electric vehicle that we've got gone round in the Nürburgring Blast, which is actually a BMW i3. So probably going to be quicker than that, and let's find out just how much quicker. Let's get to it. Right, let's wind this up for the final corner. Let's turn it, pitch it in right on the power, and let's see where we can go. Right, so cross the start finish line, hard on the brakes. Let's get this nose turned in on the power already. Rear tires kind of squabbling for grip at the back there. This car has got a lot of power and a lot of aero grip, completely flat through that section there. Down here we're going to brake as late as we dare, second stab of brake, and then we're just going to use the power and the camber of the road just to get us through that section there. A little bit wide in that first bit there, compromises for the second bit, but we brought it back. Right, focus on the exit. We're already on the power, flat out on the power there, and focusing all the way down on this exit, because we're going to go long, long straight here. You can see this car accelerates to about 220, 230 kph very, very, very quickly. But then after then, it's pretty much out of puff. You can see completely flat, no problem with the flung plats. This has got F1 levels of aero grip, but just doesn't have the forward momentum. You can see even with gravity, we're not going to go much over 252. A little bit of grass there by accident. And then flat out through there, and then we're going to spot the braking zone, brake hard for this hairpin here. Right, waiting for the front end to come to us. There it is, back on the power, and then down through the foxholes. So you can see this car really picks up speed to a certain point, and then it kind of just plateaus out. But look at the grip. So flat out through the compression, and then up over the rise again, completely flat out, and then we're right on the brakes as late as possible, and then back onto the brakes, try and spot that apex there. It's quite hard to see with the high buckets for the front wheels on this car, but you kind of just have to get a feel for where they should be, and you kind of aim for that. Right, so fast left-hander here, little dab of brakes, try and keep it under control. I would have liked to be a little bit further over to the left there, avoid that right-hand curb, but we're through, over the hill, and then back onto the brakes. Keep the car nice and tight, don't touch the curb, and then use the curb on the exit just to straighten up the car. Right, flat out through there, yep, and then a dab of brake just to settle the front of the car. There we go, really starting the motor now. Right, going to be heavy on the brakes again, straighten up, and then back onto the brakes. Look for that apex that we can't see, and then get back on the power. Yes, try not to hit that curb like I did there, because it does unsettle the rear as it did for me. And then brake quite early there, because we don't want to end up too close to that wall on the exit there. And then this corner, we're already on the power before we even got to the apex. We actually ended up out a little bit too far to the left, and I had to come back off the throttle, so I lost a little bit of time there. Flat out, and then brake when we're alongside the Yokohama side. Try and keep it nice and low. There we go. And back on the power. We want to focus on the exit as we go up the hill. Right. So you can see already the car's speeded up to its terminal velocity pretty quickly. But this is where it's going to start losing out, because it's not going to accelerate much more up this hill. This is the first time I've used race room experience since 2013. And that was on a laptop with a keyboard. So it's definitely impressing me so far. I have to say the force feedback, strength and detail is great through the steering wheel. Didn't quite have a very good line through that fast left-hander there. Got on the curb. Didn't want to do that either. Right, hard on the brakes. Down into the carousel section. So, on the power, as soon as the front end says it's got enough grip. And then up over here. So, carousel, tricky corner. On the brakes, nice and early. Let's pitch in. Let's just try and take a least resistance line through there, and then power out of the carousel. Right, into the good section, my favorite section. So right, flat out through there, and then we're going to get on the brake. Want to avoid any of the curbs in this first section here. They will put you into a spin a little bit late, and a little bit deep into that right hander here, and click the curb there, but it's okay, we're still going. Right, flat out through that first bit. A little bit of a lift through the second section. There we go. Use the curb on the exit there. and then you always get understeer there unless you can get it nice and tight. Right, down the hill we go through the forest, just trying to trace the nice line here. There we go, we can use the power on the exit. It's quite hard to judge corner speed without gears, because after a while you get used to what a fourth gear kind of corner should be in a car. This, you've got no real reference to kind of what kind of speed you're carrying other than the visual ones. Right, up over the rise, we're going to do the little jump here. Yeah, there we go, dab a brake, get that front end turned in. Front end is nailed. Up over the rise, down through onto this off camber section here. This can be quite a tricky section, but we've got so much downforce at this point that it is quite easy. Right, dab a brake, get that front end turned in, wash the wide a little bit there, a little bit of understeer, and again there, but back on the power. Second carousel, brake nice and early, get that front end in, there we go, and back onto the power. We're almost at the end of the lap. So, heading up to the final corner before we get onto the Dottinger Her. A little bit of a lift there, just use all this aero grip as we go around this long, long right corner. A lot of weight through the steering wheel. Right, now onto the Dottinger Her. Underneath the Audi Sport sign, we're at 5 minutes 30. So the lap record for this car is a 6 minute 5, I believe. So I don't think we're going to quite get to that point, but it's going to be a pretty decent lap. Trying to keep it nice and straight. You can see this is where the power really holds the car back. It's not accelerating down this long, long straight. This is over a kilometre wide. Right, easy through the Bilstein Bridge. 5 minutes 55. 10 seconds until the lap record. Right, flat out through this section here. A little bit of curb, didn't want to get on that really. Right, hard on the brakes, hard on the brakes. Turn it in. Use the curb on the entry there. Use the curb, abuse the curb there. Gone a little bit too deep into the final corner. There we go, smash the power. Out the other side. And that's a what kind of time is that? We'll wait for it to pop up. I'll have to pop it up for your screen right now. But that was a lap of the Nürburgring in the VW IDR. So, whew, I'm sweating now. This is my first time back on race room, so really enjoying it. I'm looking forward to giving the DTM content a try, because I'm a massive DTM fan. But if you enjoyed this, this was Nürburgring Blast, and there'll be another episode next week. Until then, have a good one.